r/askreddit, what is something that you learned in school but got debunked as you got older? People will be offering you drugs left and right. OMG, it made no sense whatsoever. Why would people just lace your weed with coke or acid? If drugs unavoidably destroy your life, how come so many famous people do then? And we're supposed to believe alcohol is absolutely terrible until you come of age, then it's fine. I went to school through the 90s, this is important. When we're learning about AIDS/HIV, they impressed upon us that if you so much as shook hands with someone with it, you were going to die. We know this isn't true. My mom learned it came from gay monkeys. Different parts of your tongue taste sweet/bitter, etc. We did an experiment on that in grade 4, I think. I swore I could taste everything in any spot of my tongue, but my teacher told me I was wrong, so I had to pretend I didn't before we could move on. You will never always have a calculator in your pocket, smiley face. Don't get into cars with strangers. Don't talk to people you don't know on the internet. Oh yeah? Well, for starters, this calculator is also capable of communicating with others by phone call or messaging. It also has the internet where I can look up literally anything I ever wanted to know. Checkmate, teachers. Does your generation think your teachers knew the future and were simply hiding it from you? The whole food pyramid thing with 724 daily servings of bread products on the bottom. The earth is only 3,000 to 5,000 years old. I was homeschooled and went to a private Christian school before I got to public school. Your teacher, the world is 3 years old. You, but teacher, I'm 5 years old, how can I exist? My private Christian school always taught that the earth was 4.6 billion years old. I don't remember if my grade school did, but my high school definitely did. Oh, young earth creationism. What a scam that is, eh? Learned that glass was a liquid, with the example of old church window panes being thicker at the bottom than they are at the top. Glass is not a slow-moving liquid. The glass in old church windows is not consistent thickness because of the methods used to create the glass at the time. Yeah, and if you were mounting a window that was thicker at one end, then of course you put that at the bottom. That ridiculous food pyramid. No, it isn't essential for life to eat bowls of pasta or cereal and loaves of bread every day, and fat is not some vile substance to be avoided. But I love my bowls of pasta and cereal and loaves of bread. But seriously, where is the section for daily servings of pizza? They forgot that one. There are 5 senses. Proprioception, gravity, motion, which am I forgetting? Bro, I really can't believe they convinced us to eat so much carbs, then we're shocked we got so fucking fat in America. Fruits and veggies are king, then meats to keep you full longer, and then dairy, carbs, and sweets as a treat. That we are born with all the brain cells we will ever have because new brain cells can't be created. It turned out that the belief was based on monkeys in cages. They don't create new brain cells, but monkeys who live in enriched environments with outdoor access and the ability to explore do create new brain cells. Pluto. Not really debunked so much as reclassified. Pluto is still Pluto, but planet just isn't a useful label for it. Pluto will always be a planet in my heart. You heard about Pluto? That's messed up, right? Came here to look for this or post it? Downgraded to a dwarf planet. America's going metric. They told me this in the 1970s, how about you? Gen X. Came to say this. Your high school permanent record will follow you through life. The lore behind the first American Thanksgiving. Christopher Columbus took our land back from the Indians, and that settled law, goddamn it. What's crazy is that we know it's wrong but still teach it anyway. Pour a 40 out on the curb for my poor homie, Pluto. When I was a kid, we had 9 planets. When I was a kid, we had billions. Formal education is the key to success. Shaving made hair grow back thicker. And we were told wearing a baseball cap on the crown of your head makes you go bald. The friction from wearing a hat on your head will make your hair thin. My partner's hair thins at his crown if he wears a hat for more than a few weeks, and then magically grows back when he stops for a few months. Was that ever formally taught in school? Maybe that's what your friend said in gym class, but I don't think any teachers ever taught that. Is this a USA thing? In my country we were never told anything like this. Monopoly is only fun when you play by the rules designed for the game, therefore capitalism is good. Also, the teacher left out the fact there's a Ubi in Monopoly, which is necessary for the game to function. I had to work hard to get around that board without going to jail. Found out recently that the Milgram experiment was actually flawed and manipulated participants to get the desired result, and should not be accepted as proof of how people would really behave in those circumstances. That people were warning Columbus he'd fall off the edge of the earth if he sailed too far. Virtually everyone knew the earth was round at that time, and long before. As an American, that America is the greatest country in the world. And that patriotism is not all it's cracked up to be. That America sometimes has to go to other countries and save them from their ways. George Washington had wooden teeth. He did not. The worst part is that hippo ivory teeth are cooler than wood anyway. If it makes you feel better, you can claim that he got the reputation for wooden teeth from smoking so many trees. Link. Truth is grosser than fiction. That the Berlin Wall was still up. I mean, the thing fell 6 years before they taught us about it in class, but since it wasn't updated in the textbook, by golly, that's what we were taught. True, but I don't mind kids believing this if it encourages them to behave better. We watched it come down on TV in class. It was pretty cool to see live. So much North American indigenous whitewashing. We were taught Christopher Columbus discovered the land that is now the US. Of course, later I learned the bastard didn't discover shit and literally never came to the land that is now the US. Good times. That would be Amerigo Vespucci, and he's in the chapter after Columbus. Drinking coffee stunts your growth. That I would have to write in cursive for the rest of my education. That shit stopped after middle school. You know, it was useful while doing genealogy. Most 1800s and early 1900s records were handwritten script. You all write like children over there. It's so funny. The harmful effects of MDMA even in the years after George Record's BS paper was retracted. Of course there are harmful effects. Just teach us those. Though now it has a breakthrough therapy designation from the FDA, so. I remember learning that MDMA/ecstasy took a scoop out of your brain's happiness every time you took it, so that your maximum happiness potential decreased. One dose, and you could never ever again be fully happy for the rest of your life. You're not going to have a calculator with you all the time. The Civil War was fought over states' rights that lie is big in the South. I learned about the Civil War, but my friend from farther south learned about the War of Northern Aggression. You will be safe from a nuclear attack by hiding under your desk at school. Duck and cover. Going to college was really important. It certainly can be depending on what you want to do with your life, but increasingly it's a calculation whether it's worth it to get a bachelor's degree or more given how insane costs have become. And if it's not, you have to decide whether it's better to enter the field of your choice through unconventional means or just switch to something less expensive to learn. The first one that comes to mind is, that it's impossible for a guy to urinate while erect. My biology teacher taught us that in high school and every boy in the class said ha. Nope, if that were true we'd be dead. I've had a, cis man, gym teacher tell this to a whole class of 13-year-olds and somehow my stupid ass believed it for a few years. Eventually I was like, wait, there's only one tube and that it also mean ejaculations aren't gonna happen. Being right-handed was correct. As a lefty, I always felt like I was doing something wrong. The government is your friend. To be fair, growing up phones were constantly evolving. This was true in elementary and part of middle school, but by the time I hit high school everyone had an iPhone. Remember having to read and report on news articles? One said that in 20 years there would be no more fuel for cars. I thought I would never get to drive a car. I guess they were wrong. That teachers don't fart. The entire DARE program, if anyone remembers that.